different different navigation options. The first one is going to the screens. You can navigate to a particular screen and a view. Okay. In Siebel 7, the corresponding thing is sitemap. Serves the same purpose. The salient feature is an alphabetic listing of all the screens and their views. Okay. So it will help you in getting to the place in a random fashion. Okay. Second way is you drill down. The user will drill down into some into this thing. It will take him to a certain view. Okay. Third one is, do you know any other option? Okay. Third one is user will right click and he might be able to do certain things. He might be able to navigate to certain things. So there might be certain navigation options here. For example, if you see in service request, it can take him to many things. It can take him to professionals. Okay. This is another way. There is another way. These threads. A thread gets created sometimes and user can navigate back and forth between the threads.
So Siebel 6, right?
Yeah. Oh, same. Conceptually everywhere. It's even in Amazon.com. Everything is. Last but not the least, history list. Very importantly, back and forward buttons. These are the various navigation options. Another way to, I mean, that's not navigation option, but if you search for something, it takes you away from the screen where you are and it takes you to another screen. For example, in this case, it will take you to My Professionals. This is another navigation way option. Anything else that I know that these special functionality buttons take you to sometimes, you know, different, they can take you to
some website or something like that.
No, it will take you to some other area within the application also. It can take you. Yeah, that's right. This is one way. Yeah. Anything else? Yeah. Connect. I mean, I wouldn't call it navigation option, but it takes you to the basically the login page. Okay. Okay. All right. Now, let's understand a very important concept that is called as maintaining the focus. For example, when a rep is here, he's working on this record, IBM Inc. dot, okay? If he drills down on it, he's able to maintain the focus. He's again still looking at IBM Inc. only, right? He doesn't lose the focus. Whereas, if he goes, okay, let's say he's back again. Whereas, if he goes to, let's say, service request, he's lost the focus. He's now on some other record, irrelated record. If you drill down Alexander, let's see whether it will maintain the focus or not. Yes. Drilling down maintains the focus.
But then if we click on IBM and then we go to service requests.
So if I drill down on this thing, then again it is maintaining the focus. It is showing only for that professional. I'm not sure how, but it typically does basically. Okay, so this let's talk about the thread bar also maintains the focus. Right click also maintains the focus. It is again an Alexander Mary only. If a person history list, that helps in maintaining the focus too. So I'm back to the same record, so it helps in maintaining the focus. Okay, wherever I was, back and this one, they also maintain the focus. Same button, same record in the same view opens. Okay.
But what if
the focus is one concept that I wanted to let you know. Okay. Other thing is, let's see whether, you know, like this is a small thing, you know, actually someone asked one of my guys, this is an MVG, right? The hyperlinks are not possible in MVGs. Just to let you know.
Okay.
To navigate to MVG or any kind of pickup thread, you have to simply open this button and then there is no way to navigate away except to close it. Mm-hmm. Okay. A typical thing which helps in maintaining the focus is if a customer rep highlights a record, he can go to different views. It will maintain the focus. Going to a separate screen does not maintain the focus, okay? Mm-hmm. But this one does. Important thing to note is this is the most important thing that a rep uses. He puts an account and then looks at various children entities or various children records of that account. This is the most used functionality. Other most used functionality is drill down.
Screen.
This drill down is very important from a BA standpoint, from a design standpoint. It basically, let's say the process is that, you know, he should create an account, then he should create a contact, then the rep should create an opportunity. We typically ask him, create an account, drill down on account name. Create a contact, drill down on it. Then we basically, when he drills down, we take him to the specific view. Obviously, this is a configurable item. So then we can, you know, we configure it that way. Let's say their process is that, you know, after account, contact, opportunity, then they are supposed to simply create an order, not a code. So we can just make sure that when they drill down opportunity name, it takes them to the order. Okay. So we talked about two concepts. One is maintaining the focus. Second thing is implementing a process flow. Anything else? Another very important thing which is used for maintaining the process flow is imparting the process flow is right click. Highlight and right click. So let's say you want him to enter after an opportunity, he must enter an activity. I mean, obviously this is out of the box. Vanilla is not really supporting any process flow, but then you can use it to implement a process flow. Although threads look quite powerful, they are useless in SQL, pretty much. They don't use that much. Like in Amazon.com, etc., the threads are very useful, but in case of SQL, threads are not useful. And by the way, thread is created only when a person drills down on something. For example, let's say a person is here, a rep is here. I think I didn't tell about that. So he creates, like, see, thread got, created. Okay. So whenever he drills down, then only the thread got created. That's why drill downs are used the most. So if he wants to go back at random, he can either go through history list or he can go through